All right, welcome back, guys. Welcome back to another video here today. Today we are going to be reading a post from R K9Boy on r/AskReddit. People with Aspergers, what's Aspergers really like? Okay, I'm not going to waste a whole lot of time here, so let's go ahead and get right into this one. It's like living in a foreign country, in which it seems like everyone except for you knows the customs, understands the language, and fully grasps the unwritten rules of that society. You want to ask for help, but you don't know how because nobody speaks your language. And even if somebody does try to explain it, it still makes no sense to you. Eventually, you force yourself to learn to adapt, to act like you know what you're doing, because you know if you don't, you can't survive in this confusing place. You can never be your true self, it seems. Unless you're lucky enough to find others who also speak and understand your language. At least, that's how it is to me. This. You also feel like what you're feeling isn't right according to other people because you're sensitive. If I'm not sensitive, then it's harder for me to pick up on others' emotions. I'm not trying to make it all about me if someone acts a certain way around me that doesn't correspond with another person. I'm just trying to learn and adapt to my behaviors. It's also hard when people get mad at you for something you didn't realize was upsetting them, and them never talking to you. Sometimes being subtle about your hints doesn't work with someone with Asperger's. Just be upfront and kind when addressing an issue. If you just come out of the gate with anger to someone, especially someone with Asperger's who doesn't know they've caused an issue, it's very jarring. Also, telling people to stop when they are overstimulating you through pestering and getting blamed when you blow up. You feel as if you're 90% while everyone else is 100%, and you can't break that 90% barrier. You forget that your thoughts, while connected in your head through a map, make sense to you, but randomly blurting out about cathedral spires in a conversation about turtles looks kind of odd and comes off a bit rude. I've been described as rude, but never mean or offensive. I'm always making an effort to correct any wrong behavior, and I won't let somebody turn away when I'm certain I said something that upset them. The last part has made having a relationship 100 times easier because we discuss anything we happen to fight about or was said or ignored and learn from it. Don't go to bed angry at each other sort of deal. Personally, social interactions are hard. Social cues are missed. Subtle hints are lost, etc. I pissed off plenty of people and weirded out many more. But the worst thing about it is not understanding myself. Sometimes I feel angry, sad, or happy about something, but I'm not sure. And I can't tell if anybody else feels the same, but I don't want them to be angry. So I hide all my emotions. I'm a very curious person. My interests are sporadic and many. Black holes, cars, world history, food, cultures, computers, etc. Certain sounds and physical feelings are uncomfortable. I am 19, a manager in my company, and I am independent. I am successful, but sometimes it's hard to believe. This is Asperger's for me. I can see the reason people do all the things they do. Talk with varying pitches, dress in coordinated clothing, smile and make eye contact at the right time, but I just can't seem to get the hang of any of it. I understand why all that stuff would be important, but no matter how much I study other people, I can't make myself act like them 100%. People always immediately identify me as weird 20 seconds into a conversation. Imagine you're a scared little turtle. You're immensely shy and like to hide in your shell most of the time. When you do come out, you get scared easily by loud noises, bright lights, and other intense stimuli. When you get scared, you retreat into your shell and shut down completely, cutting out the outside world. Sometimes you might get aggressive when scared and lash out. When you do come out, you operate on a strict activity schedule and the slightest difference in it can send you back into your shell. But your loved ones are patient with you and they care about you for all your little quirks and love that you are very passionate about something. New friends are tough to find, but you eventually find them that like similar things. You learn to cope with things and start not to hide in your shell all that often. But it's still there when you need to take a break from the world. Being super sensitive to noise. Being sensitive to certain fabrics. Going on and on about your favorite subject and the other person is clearly bored or annoyed. Wishing other people realized I can't handle loud noisy cars and that's why I'm covering my ears. Being self-conscious about everything. For me, it involves a fear of getting too close to people. Or a fear of pushing people away without realizing it until it's too late. Or having a plan for literally everything. It's hard to provide specific details because it's just kind of life. I can say I've been very excited about certain things, and I really just want the people around me to be equally excited. I like understanding how people think, but I'm not great at it. I could never really tell how much my friends like me. I've had some really fulfilling friendships that just sort of ended without warning, and it's very confusing. I read about all of these really great lifelong friendships, and I realize that I've not had the opportunity to experience something like that. But yeah, I mean, it's manageable, I guess. It's often hard to sit down. You feel uncomfortable no matter how much you shift. You often fear that you have an odor about you that everyone can smell except for you. Like you've become accustomed or nose deaf. But when you walk past people, you think that they're making comments about you after you've gone by. But on the plus side, whenever I get hungry, I just have to reach into the back of my pants and pull out a Royale with cheese. Now imagine mixing ASD with OCD. Not only can I really stop thinking about certain things, but I also have to overanalyze them to no end. Yet I would never try to share this analysis with anybody else because I fear how someone, even my family, would react to it. ASD is pretty much +3 to intelligence, but -4 to charisma. And in my case, I can never shake that feeling that I'm being judged for everything I do, not to mention the motor skills that I lack. I'm 18, yet I cannot even prepare my own meals, nor can I take an effective shower or bath. With communication in mind, I'm too shy to directly speak to most people. And then when I do, my ASD and OCD lead me to discuss one thing that they sort of do understand to no end until they just kind of cut me off or walk away. I know every case is different, but this is my experience. Some people can overcome ASD, but sadly, that is not my only mental inhibition. Wow, almost everything I've experienced has been described here. And I haven't even read all the comments. I'll try not to repeat anybody. I feel like high-functioning autism is made to really mess with your sense of self. All of my life, I've been told I'm smart because of my symptoms, but it's always more been for things like speaking in monotone or learning a lot about some random thing and being able to regurgitate that information, among other things. At the same time, other symptoms of HFA severely hinder my performance at school and in most academic measures of intelligence. So my whole life, I've grown up with most adults I've met thinking I'm a savant at my school telling me I'm retarded. You get caught in this flip-flop of extremes and are never sure how to look at the world. It really ducks with your head. It's led to a lot of self-loathing and self-destructive behavior. Has anyone else experienced this? In my experience, it has been one of the worst and life-ruining parts of having Asperger's. And the most relevant answers in my experience to what Asperger's really like. To keep it simple, I always feel like an alien from another world that is blending in on Earth. I felt adopted and like an outcast my entire life. Nothing other people do makes sense. I don't get subtle hints. I don't understand why people have moods. I can't tell when they are in moods or switched. Talking and explaining things is either not enough information or so much, people get overwhelmed. It's a persistent feeling of being alone no matter how hard you try to adapt. Mix that with extreme depression and PTSD from childhood and life gets hard. I managed to survive by memorizing what people consider normal and staying within those boundaries. I could go on for days. I also have ADHD and was abused in my early childhood, so my experience may not entirely be the result of Asperger's, but I tend to ask for help a lot more than I really should because I am not confident in my own ability to perform whatever task that I'm trying to do. This does not extend to things I really should be asking for help about, such as making sense of my own personality or seeing a therapist, simply because I don't know how to ask for help in that situation. I am terrified of people losing all respect they have for me / getting pissed at me because of some little thing that I did that in reality, nobody cares about. This has led to people getting pissed at me for refusing to do something they told me to do because I was afraid it might piss somebody off. I am a massive introvert and have very few friends and no true friends. I am still a virgin, and I have never asked anyone out on a date because I was terrified they might already be in a relationship and thus get pissed at me for daring to ask. I never ask if they're in a relationship either because I'm worried they might think that I'm creepy. I often forget important things and have lost multiple arguments simply because I could not think of any examples of how to back up my argument, even though I knew I had some. My mind shuts down when I'm doing paperwork and I literally cannot force myself to think of anything at all. There's probably some more, but this is all I could think of as of now. Everywhere you enter, you are always like the new kid, even when you're almost grown and you are not here for the first time. Some things like unwritten rules, customs are either confusing for you or even seems weird to you, and you never know if you're doing it right. Sometimes people yell at you and think that you're crazy and you have no idea why. Alright, and that takes us to the end of the video. If you made it all the way to the end, thank you. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more mental health Reddit videos and share your thoughts below. I'm starting this channel to help out viewers out there with issues related to mental health and giving us a place to gather and share our stories. I should be uploading 3 times a week going forward, so be on the lookout. Until next time, peace.